In this video, I will show you how to use the transparency tool in CorelDRAW. We will review a variety of exercises on how to use the different types of transparencies and how to adjust some settings for each. Before we get started, let's review where the transparency tool is inside the CorelDRAW interface. The transparency tool is located on the left-hand toolbar right above the eyedropper. If you click on the transparency tool, the property bar will change to the basic options for transparency, and you'll see the five types of transparency. Uniform transparency, fountain transparency, vector pattern transparency, bitmap pattern transparency, and two color patterns. Now, if you click on a transparency object, you'll get even more options. The first section here that is for all the transparencies, you'll get the merge modes choices. You get the transparency picker, so each kind of transparency will have its own options inside the picker. You'll have some percentage adjustments. Some will have one or two. Since we have a uniform one, it's only showing one adjustment for the transparency level. You can apply the transparency to all of the object, the fill and the outline. You can apply it just to the fill. You can apply it just to the outline. You can freeze the transparency where the transparency moves with the object. You can copy it from another object, and this is a critical one, is the Edit Transparency dialog box has even more options to be able to edit your transparencies. In this exercise, we're going to use transparency to improve our t-shirt mock-up so it looks more realistic. Sometimes when you have a solid color on a t-shirt mock-up, it looks kind of fake and like a sticker, so transparency can just soften it a little bit to make it look more realistic. So let's click on a logo that's laying on the t-shirt, come over to our transparency tool, come up to the uniform transparency and click on it. It'll use the last setting that the tool was used, so that's too light for us unless you're trying to really get a distressed or washed out look. But now we can adjust this to say down to 10 or 15% and it'll just be soft enough to where it doesn't look like a sticker, it looks like ink on the garment. And let's show you how really that helps that design a lot. So if we select both of these, we're going to duplicate them and pull them across to the side here. I'll show you how to actually remove a transparency as well. So now if we click on our logo again and go back to the transparency tool, if you want to remove it, this very first button is what removes the transparency. So now even though it's a subtle difference, that little bit of lightness of transparency makes that look like it's really on the shirt versus laying on top with this one. Another use for uniform transparency is to add a color cast to a photo. In this exercise, we will create a color cast on a photo to be used for a Facebook cover image. Our musician's name is Shamrock Dan, and he has a great photo, but he wants to use a green theme on his Facebook header. So we can add green color cast to this image. But first, we need a rectangle to apply the color and the transparency. So let's select our photo here, and then let's hold shift on our keyboard and come over here and click the rectangle tool and double click. What that does is it creates a rectangle around our image, and right now it's set to no fill with an outline. But let's come over here and find a good green to apply it to the image, but right now it's still 100% solid. So now let's go apply our transparency, click on our transparency tool, then click on the uniform fill, and now we can adjust it the way we want. So you can adjust it up here, or there is also a little dialog thing down here to help you adjust it on the fly. So we can go, if you just want a slight hint of green, you can go there, or if you want a heavy green, you can go here. And if we want our type on the top, let's lasso our type, and let's do control and page up on your keyboard, and that'll bring that to the top. And there's our image with a color cast. And if you come to Halloween or Mardi Gras and you want to change that color cast, click on the green and let's make it a purple. Or if we're doing a Halloween gig, we can make it orange. And that's how easy it is to add a color cast to a photo. In this exercise, we're going to show you how to create a highlight on a web button and a bulb using fountain transparency. So our web button here has two shapes. It has the red main shape and it has a white shape laying on top that we're going to turn into a highlight using the transparent fountain transparency. So if we come down to our transparency tool and select it, you can automatically click right on fountain, or you can draw interactively with transparency right on the object and apply it. So let's click once and then drag down about halfway through the button and let go. And it turned it into a fountain transparency, going from the white to the black, which means transparent. But it's not quite right, so we can adjust it now to make it look even better. So if we click on our little black square here and we start dragging up, we get that bottom line to fade off into the button. So let's drag a little more, a little more. And if we let go here and if I click off, now it's faded and looks shiny. Okay, now on our bulb, it's built the same way where we have a background shape and we have the highlight shape. So let's go click our transparency tool and let's apply the transparency to this one. We'll draw from the center out. But that created a default linear transparency. There's multiple types of fountains. We have linear, we have elliptical, we have conical, and we have rectangular fountain transparency. But for this one, we need the elliptical. So let's click on elliptical, but it's still not quite right. Let's click on the blue edge of our circle here so we can drag this to the center of it to see how we're doing. And it's still not quite right, so we need to go edit the properties of this, and we need to reverse the colors so it fades from the white on the inside to the black on the outside, which will be fading the outside edge. So let's click on our edit transparency dialog box. And the option we need is this reverse transparency. So it's going to flip the black and the white so that they're opposite of the way they are now. So let's click it. So as you see in the preview here, it swapped the colors. Let's click OK and go see how it's looking, and we can adjust it some more. So same thing as the other one. We got kind of hard edges here. We can pull it in a little bit till it gets lined up like that. And now if we select and click off, there's our highlight. It looks like our bulb is shiny. Let's go back to our Shamrock Dan image, and I want to show you some of the advanced options and some of the fountain fills and cool techniques you can use to create some great effects. So let's turn it back to green, select on our transparency, let's send it back to green, let's draw transparency on here to make it a fountain. And if you come up here, you can go to the transparency picker, and if you come down here to the options on the side and choose fountain pack, it's going to give you all kinds of options, and you can adjust the size of the thumbnails. They're a little tricky to see, but you can click on them and just see what kind of effects they have going on in your design. Kind of cool here. But I found one I kind of liked. It was this one, and because it kind of looks like the stage lights and things like that. So instead of a solid green tint, we can adjust this any way we want. And put the center of it where it looks like it's coming from the back, and it looks like the band lights on a stage. That's kind of cool. Another cool thing with the transparency I haven't shown you yet is the merge modes. So up here, that's what the merge rows. Right now, this is set to normal, but you can choose all these other options in here to create all different effects. Like if we wanted to create a sepia tone, let's change this green to yellow. And so, oops, we gotta have our selection tool to change the color back. So let's click on the selection tool and make it yellow. But that's kind of gaudy looking. So let's use the merge mode to see if we can look at kind of more like a bar and all that. So let's choose color burn and see what that looks like. There, see how that kind of adds a tone to it, but it's just not, it's a more subtle. We could try orange and see if that's got a little more feel to it. See, that has a little different feel to it. And same kind of thing. And then if we don't like our band lights, we can go back and we can make it solid again and click on our solid uniform transparency. So it has a little more sepia look, but it's not quite there yet. So we could either lighten it or darken it and experiment and see. See, now it's looking more like sepia. That looks pretty sweet. It's got just a little hint of orange to it, and it's a different kind of look for that photo.
Okay, in our next exercise, I'm going to show you how to use some vector, bitmap, two-color, and texture transparencies to create a totally different look. First, let's go do a uniform transparency again just to show you the difference. So let's click on our transparency tool, and we'll click on our uniform transparency. Remember, it's the same amount of lightness applied to the object, so we can lighten it and darken it based on just solid fills. But now, if we come over to the vector transparency, click on that. So, and we'll come over here to our transparency picker, then we'll come over here to our starter pack, and it gives us some vector choices. So now if we click through a couple of these, you can see how so different they are versus the uniform. Let's find one we like here, and let's try that one. So now you can't see very much contrast, but with this transparency, you have two choices for the levels to adjust. You can adjust the foreground and the background. So if you want it lighter or darker, you want it super soft, or if you want more contrast, you can adjust these to be whatever you need. And we'll go back to what we had there. Go down a little contrasty there. Also, with these type of patterns, you can adjust the scale. So if you don't want a giant motif like that, you can reduce it. And you can even turn it on an angle and get a totally different look. So there you got a neat looking thank you card. The next one I'll show you here is, I'm going back to my transparency tool, and is the bitmap transparency. Then we'll also go to the transparency picker again, go to starter pack, and it's going to give you totally different types of options. These are bitmaps that have lots of other different textures and things like that, to where they're almost photographic, to where then same thing, if you click off of it, you can adjust each transparency part up or down and to get a totally different look. I like it darker like that. Before we move on to the next type of transparency, I want to show you where to get some extra content for the bitmap and vector transparencies. You can go back up to your transparency picker and go to the options on the right hand side and click the drop down. Come all the way down to the bottom and click add new. When we click get more, it will take us to the Get More area, and under the Content tab, you'll have some options that you can download and install for free. And once they're installed, they're in your library. Let's close this. And if you're in a previous version of CorelDRAW, those textures and patterns will already be displayed in the Transparency Picker. And you'll see on mine, under the Content, here's the bitmap packs and stuff already installed. The next one is two color patterns. It has some drop downs here where you can create a neat effect as well, where you start out with it big, but you don't like that. You can create it on an angle and way small, and then you want the little less contrast to be softer. It can be super soft, or we can go down a little more to where that's pretty neat. Okay, the last transparency I want to show you is the texture transparency. So if we come up here back to our two color where we were, but you have to click on the little black arrow here, and it will show you a drop down and click on texture transparency. So that's going to change our options again. So here we have some sample libraries to choose from, but I'm going to choose just stick with the basics of the samples. And if we click on this drop down, it's going to show us our options inside that first samples library. So we can just click on one to see what it looks like. And then same thing, you can adjust your foreground and your background again to make it however you need to give it soft or more contrast. Let's switch back to another one here. Let's go back to this one. And same thing, and with these, you can adjust the scale as well and make it small or on an angle or straight. And don't forget, you can also change your background color of your square to then see what another looks like. So if we go back on our pick tool, and then let's find a green color, and we can experiment. I think I like that one better. And then we can change our text to green. Now you have a totally different look. Thank you for watching. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial and the exercise file to follow along. You will also find other helpful tutorials on CorelDRAW.